Welcome to GeoVision video tutorial. My name is Aaron and today I'll be introducing our ASManager access control software. Okay, so this is the outline for the presentation today. So the first one will be the goal, what you can learn from this presentation, followed by the introduction of the ASManager, and then followed by the features of ASManager, so what you can do with the software, and then a case study of ASManager, followed by live demo of some of the configurations of ASManager with some of the access control hardware that GeoVision has. Lastly, we have the FAQ section. The goal of this presentation is to let you understand the features of ASManager and then understand some of the remote features of AS Web and AS Remote. And then we also have a function called here Web, so we also introduce the features and what kind of reports you can generate with it. Lastly, we have the VM Web, so we also introduce VM Web to you, let you know how you can configure it. Okay, so what is ASManager? It's actually a access control software that you can use to monitor all your DOS status. You can also use it to control access rights of different card users. And also, you can use it for the TA function, time attendance function. So HR department can easily calculate how much pay they want to give to each employee based on their attendance. And then lastly, you can also manage visitor access with the VM Web. Okay, so let's go on to the network structure for ASManager. As you can see on the left, you have the ASManager installed in the PC. You can connect it through TCP/IP to AS controllers like regular DOS controllers or even elevator controllers EV48. You can also connect the readers either from GeoVision or third-party readers using RS-485 or Wigan to the controllers, and then users can just swipe cards at the readers to open doors. And in ASManager, you'll be able to see the status of the card swipes and also the door status. Okay, so you can follow this flowchart when adding AS controller to ASManager. So first, you add the controller to the ASManager, followed by adding the doors, how many doors you want. And then you connect the readers to the controllers. Once the readers are connected, you can just swipe a card at the controller and then ASManager should come up with the card info and then you can add it from ASManager. And then you can also do some testing and see if the cards can be read by the readers. Once the testing is done and everything is working fine, you can set your weekly schedule, like what time you want the door to be accessed, and also set the holidays. One thing to take note when adding the AS controller to ASManager, you have to make sure that the device ID, password, the crypto key, and the device login ID and password are all matching in ASManager and the AS controller. Okay, this is the network structure for remote accessing of ASManager. You can either use AS Web, which is done using browser, or AS Remote, which is installed on other PCs. You can connect them using TCP/IP to ASManager, and inside the AS Web and AS Remote, you'll be able to see the access logs. We also have a mobile application called GV-Access. You can download this from Android Google Play Store or the iOS App Store. So this is free, and you can use the mobile phone to connect directly to ASManager. Okay, so this is the minimum PC spec for ASManager. The requirement is quite low, as you can see. We only require a Core 2 Duo CPU and then only 2 GB of dual channel RAM. However, if you are having cameras viewing live in ASManager, then we will recommend that you connect a gigabit LAN. Just a regular graphics card will do with 32-bit color. For the OS, well, we support both 32-bit and 64-bit. This is the dongle rule for ASManager. The first four controllers that you connect to ASManager, you can use it free of charge. However, once you add the fifth controller, you will have to buy a 5-port dongle from us. The maximum number of controllers supported in ASManager is 1,000. Let's go on to the features of ASManager. So inside ASManager, you can see the event logs where you can see the card number of the user photograph, and then their names, or even door access times and which door they are accessing. You can also integrate GV-IP cameras or third-party cameras using ONVIF, PSIA, or RTSP protocols. So this way, you will be able to see the live view streams inside ASManager. You can also do playback if you are using GV-DVR or MVR. So you can add the GV-DVR MVR into ASManager, and then you'll be able to playback the events. ASManager also supports our GV-AS1010 reader, which has a built-in TA functions. We also have the remote lockdown application where users can use it to lock down all the doors in case of emergencies. We also support three types of database: Microsoft Access, SQL Database, and Windows Active Directory. In case of database corruption, users can use ASDB Manager, which is found inside the Access Control folder, to restore their database or even repair. ASManager can also send a notification when an event happens, like invoke alarm, PC alarm. You can also send an email notification. You can also trigger recording when an event happens, or even trigger preset goal. So you can have a PDZ camera point to one of the presets when an event happens, like pointing to one of the readers when a card is swiped. You can also pop up live view of the cameras. You can also assign different access groups to receive different notifications. So for example, we have different departments. Different departments can receive different notifications for different events. There are different kinds of access modes when you are setting the access schedule for the different doors. So the first one would be card mode, where users can only swipe cards to open doors. The second one would be card and PIN code mode. So users have to swipe and input their PIN code, 4 digits. The third one would be card or common mode. So they can either use their card or just the PIN code to open the doors. The next one would be release mode, where users can swipe to keep all the doors in unlocked status. The last one would be release by card. So this is used in combination with the release mode. So only when a card is swiped, then the door will become release mode. Next, we'll go on to some other features of ASManager. So the first one would be anti-duress. So for example, today if you are being followed or you are held hostage and forced to open a door for someone else, then you can use the anti-duress mode. So for example, you just swipe your card and then input your PIN code and add a 1 to the last digit. So for example, if your PIN code is 1234, then you can just input 1235. And then in ASManager, you'll be able to see the anti-duress signal. Next, we have interlock function, where one door has to be closed first before the second can be opened. So this is mostly used in jail, where the prisoners is brought in, and also in laboratories, where you have to go into chamber first before you can enter your lab. Next, we have the A plus B card. So this is used in banks, where two supervisors has to swipe their cards at the same time in order to open the vault. Next is the patrol tour time, where you can set a patrol card for one of the security guards. So at a specific time, they have to go and present this card to the reader to make sure that they were on patrol. And then we have the lock card time, where you can specify a time for each card to access only once. So let's say in employee or school cafeteria, they are only allowed to enter the cafeteria once for meal. So you can set it from, let's say, 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Each card can only enter the cafeteria once. Lastly, we have the lockdown function, where administrator or users can remotely lock down all the doors in the ASManager. So this is used in a case of emergencies. And also, you can unlock the doors remotely in ASManager. We also have anti-passback features. So let's say today your card, you swipe enter a door and then your card is lost. Someone tries to take your card and then access the same door again, then they will be blocked from entering the door since you did not exit. And then we have the local anti-passback function, where this is used across multiple controllers. So for example, the multiple controllers of a room or a floor, you can do a local anti-passback within that area. And then we have also a global anti-passback. This is for sites with more controllers. So let's say across different buildings, you can also set a map where you can set different areas, so you can track where the person is when he swipes the card. Next feature is the access group function, where you can assign many people into an access group. So this is for easier management of multiple users. So first you can set up a access group, and then you can add multiple cards or users into the access group. And then for each access group, they can have their own access schedule. Another function is the data group. So this is used for like different companies within a building. So each company can have their own data group and they will have their own privileges. There are three types of privileges for each data group. Privilege to read, to view settings, and then to write, so they can change their own settings or access controls schedule. And then execute, such as execute functions like opening the doors or disabling alarms within their own data group. Okay, now I'll go on to the remote access features for ASManager. So the first one would be AS Web, where you can use the browser to remotely connect to ASManager. So when you use the AS Web browser, you can remotely view event logs like alarm and access logs. You can also view snapshots or videos, clips of events. You can also remotely add or delete cards, users, controllers, access groups, and even cameras. You can also export logs that you query. So you can export them in Excel, text file, HTML file, or zip file. Next one is the AS Remote app that you can install on other PCs to connect to ASManager. So for AS Remote, you can remotely view live view and playback of the events. You can also remotely stop alarm or force door to be locked or unlocked. And then let's say you have you are using different data groups. You can also have different data group users with different privileges to remotely access your GV-ASManager information. So let's say today I'm a data group 1 user with no access rights to data group 2, then I'll not be able to see. Okay, so this is the UI for AS Remote. It looks a lot like ASManager itself. So you can also set different alarm monitors or even access monitors. You can also see live view, and you can also see user information and snapshots when the access is granted. The last remote access application that you can use to remotely access ASManager is GV-ASManager. It's available in iOS and Android. You can remotely connect up to 5 ASManagers. You can also view live view of the cameras with associated doors. You can also remote control doors such as force unlock, force open, or disable the door, or even lock down. You can also check for some of the door status like held open, tamper, or anti-duress. Okay, so this is the UI of GV-ASManager. So as you can see, you can remotely unlock door, force unlock, force lock, disable door operation, or do a remote lockdown. You can also check the door status like alarm, fire alarm, or tailgating, duress, or even access denied. Let's take a look at the main difference between ASManager, ASWeb, and AS Remote. So as you can see, you can do most of the functions in ASManager, whereas in ASWeb, you can only do live view and schedule of the doors. In AS Remote, you can only do live view and remote lock and unlock. Okay, next I'll go on to introducing our tier web and VM web. So what is tier web? Tier web is actually an ASManager function that you can access by the web browser. You can use it to manage your employees' time attendance, and then you can also create different types of reports and also calculate the payroll for them at the end of the month. Here are the features for tier web. First, you can configure the schedules for different employees or different departments. You can also do a payroll calculation based on employees' hourly pay. You can also check your employees' time attendance if they are on time or they are late for work. You can also generate time attendance and payroll reports and export them. Let's take a look at some of the reports that you can generate for tier web. The first one would be employee schedule. So you can run this report to check your employee's work schedule. Next one would be employee time card. So you can use this report to check what time your employees get to work and when they leave work. You can also do employee payroll. So here you can check their hourly pay, how much their total work hours is, and then how much you have to pay them, let's say for a particular month. Can calculate the total pay. You can also do daily time card to check the employees in and out for, let's say, a specific department or all the departments. You can also do a time card list. So with this, you can run a filter to check if employees who come early, or they come late, or they work overtime. can also do payroll list. So this is to report the hourly pay, total work hours, and total pay in the entire department. For the following three types of reports, you can do view them in a chart. So for average hour summary, you can run a report for the average working hour of your employees. This is done in a line chart. And then you can do an exception summary of the time attendance. So you can run the report and it will give you the total count of, let's say, employee start work late or overtime. So this is done in also a line chart. And then you have the payroll summary, which shows the average payroll of the department and the percentile. This is done using a pie chart. Okay, so this is the exception for the exception summary. So as you can see, you have the enter late or leave early, and then overtime or miss punch. This is the flowchart that you can refer to when setting up a tier web. So first, you can set up your TA shift, and then TA template, your schedule, and then your holidays, and then also your users and their payroll. And then lastly, you can generate TA reports based on requirements. Okay, so first you set up the TA shift. So to set up TA shift, you have to set the work schedule for each day. So let's say you set the start work time and the end work time. And then for the advanced period, it's the number of hours that employees can arrive early for work. The extended period is the amount of hours that they can work overtime for. And then you have the overtime buffer period, which is the buffer before the overtime starts. And then you can also define our break time, when is the break starting and when it ends. After you have set the TA shift, you can use the TA template. So you can add a template and then assign the shift to the template with a working cycle of 1 to 45 days. Okay, then for the TA schedule, here you can assign your shift or your templates to your schedule for let's say different departments. Lastly, you can set up the TA holiday. You can choose whichever days is a public holiday and then just set it so the shifts will not count. Next, you have to go to TA user. Here you have to set the usernames and then their hourly regular pay and then hourly overtime pay before you can complete your TA web setting. Finally, once the schedule is completed, you can go to TA report and run reports for your payroll or even a time card. The last feature I'll introduce for ASManager is a VM web, which you can access using a browser to connect to ASManager. This is used to manage your visitors' access, where they can request for a permission. Here are the features for VMWeb. You can use VMWeb by connecting to ASManager remotely using browser. So this is used to create a visitor database and also grant access when a visitor requests for permission to access the compound. You can also do visitor record search. And visitors can also use the VMWeb to register for their own access. Okay, this is the UI for a visitor database. So as you can see, you can do some filters to search for visitors, either by a company or name, employee ID, etc. You can also edit or delete your visitor database. You can also look at the demands for visits. So let's say today a visitor self-registered themselves. You can choose which card to assign to them and whether to grant them permission. Once permission is granted and a card is assigned to the visitor, then the visitor will be checked in. They can either check out manually or automatically. So by manual, the security guard can just check out the visitor manually by clicking on the checkout button. Or you can also define that when the visitor swipes the card at one of the readers, then they'll automatically check out. Okay, so this is the flowchart for VMWeb. So security guard can create the visitor profile and then issue a card. And then at the end of the day, the visitor can either check out manually by the security guard or automatically when they swipe the card at one of the doors. Next is the flowchart for visitor self-registration. So visitor can create their own profile online and then the security guard can choose whether to grant permission and to issue the card. So first, the VM administrator has to set up their mail server. and then we'll send an email to the visitor to register an account. And then once the visitor activates their account and send a request, then the admin can choose to give them permission or not. So this is the self-registration setup for the mail server. Okay, so you have to set up mail server here first before visitors can register. Once the visitor connects to the visitor login, they can register a visitor account. And then once they have registered this, we will send an email to them. Like this, this is the confirmation letter for registration of the visitors. So once the visitor sends a request for their permission, then in the VM web, the security guard or the admin will be able to see the request and whether to grant them permit. Let's go on to the case study for ASManager. So let's look at the lock card time feature. So we have customers who use this feature at a cafeteria. So they only allow the employees to enter the cafeteria once during a specific time. So the same employee won't be able to have their free lunch twice. For the live demo, we'll have another live demo video clip. So these are the topics that we'll go through in the video clip. How to add a controller like door controllers and elevator controllers. How to create user under a data group for access. And then how to set up a PTZ camera to go to preset when access is granted on one of the readers or doors. And then how to enroll fingerprint on Joe fingerprint readers. How to sync fingerprint from ASManager to the fingerprint readers. And how to do some search or query in AS Web. How to configure AS Remote. And then how to set up and generate reports in TA Web. And also how to set up a VM Web. We will also teach you how you can recover your ASManager database when it's corrupted, how you can configure and view with a GVSS application on your mobile phones, and how to set up the remote lockdown application. For the end of this video tutorial, we have the FAQ section. So frequently asked questions would be when fire alarm is enabled, can all the doors be opened automatically? The answer is yes. In the controller's web UI, you can go to a fire section under events and select unlocked. This way, the doors will all open when a fire alarm occurs. So if your user would like to have every door open when a fire alarm is triggered, they can connect all the input trigger of fire alarm with a button. So once they press the button, then all the doors will open at the same time. This is the end of the video tutorial. If you need more product information, you can go to our website at www.geovision.com.tw. If you have any technical questions and you need our help, you can also email them to support@geovision.com.tw. Thank you.